Did you know that you're overpaying your taxes by about $5,000 this year? And you did the same thing last year? In fact, I'll bet you overpaid your taxes by at least $100 this week alone. This video will explain why that happened and, more importantly, how not to let it happen again. Let's start keeping your money in your pocket where it belongs. When you begin paying less taxes, it feels kind of like giving yourself a huge pay raise. How can you do that? Well, by learning just a few tax secrets that will put a significant amount of extra money in your pocket, and it can start almost immediately. I'm Dr. Ron Mueller. My expertise is in a specialized field called home business tax law. I'm also the author of a best-selling book called Home Business Tax Savings Made Easy. The best part's those last two words. I've spoken to hundreds of audiences across the country over the past 10 years, helping tens of thousands of people just like you to save enormous amounts of money on their taxes, legally, morally, and ethically, I may add. When I talk to my audiences, I usually begin by asking them what their largest household expenses are. So let's start there. What are your largest expenses? When you sit down at the kitchen table to pay your bills once or twice a month, what are the biggest ones you pay? Housing, your health care expenses, food costs, transportation? Those are the four I hear the most often. But are you sure those are your biggest expenses? I don't think so. The answer is no. It's your taxes. That's right, your taxes. Taxes are costing you more than your housing, your health care, your food, and your transportation combined. The average person loses about 45% of their income to taxes. And federal, state, and county income taxes is just the beginning. Don't forget sales taxes, property tax, personal property taxes, gas tax, Medicare, Social Security, unemployment taxes, and a host of other taxes. After paying all those taxes, you know what you're left with? About half, or sometimes even less than half, of your hard-earned income to live on. In fact, after Uncle Sam and his friends are finished sucking a lot of cash out of your wages, you get to live on the leftovers. That's called your take-home pay. Then after you pay your bills for housing, health care, food, and transportation, by now you've only got about 20% left of your original wages to pay for everything else in your household. That's why your pockets are always empty. Uncle Sam has you upside down shaking the cash out of your pocket consistently. So what are your options? Most people will say you only have two. Make more or spend less, right? Well, how can we make more money? You could get a new job, get a second or third job, send your spouse or your kids to work, borrow money, go further in debt, try the lottery. I mean, those are not attractive options. Or let's try spending less. How do we do that? Downsize your lifestyle, clip coupons, cancel cable service, cut your own hair maybe, eliminate entertainment. I mean, that's no fun. Those are not good options either. But thank goodness there's a third option, and it's a far better option. You want to know a secret? When you begin a home-based business, you can develop a fresh new stream of long-term residual income and once and for all eliminate anxiety over things like downsizing, firing, salary freezes, workplace conflicts. And you know what? Uncle Sam will actually pay you to start that business. Option three not only sets you free from any caps on the income you can earn, but it also qualifies you for tax deductions so big that they can often slash your total income tax bill by 30, 40, sometimes even 50%. Congress has approved several huge tax incentives available only to home-based business owners. We're talking little-known, almost hidden information that even most tax preparers are not aware of. Yet these special provisions for home-based business owners are all printed in black and white right there in the federal tax code, which means they're 100% legal and 100% audit-proof. Here's how easy Congress has made it for you to qualify for these huge tax breaks. The law says any taxpayer who runs a legitimate home-based business, either on a full-time or part-time basis, needs to meet only two requirements. One, run your business on a regular and consistent basis. That's been defined by the tax courts as meaning as little as 3 to 4 hours a week. The second requirement is even easier to meet, and that's run your business with the intent to make a profit. You don't even have to actually make a profit. The intent will do. How easy can that be, meeting those two simple requirements? The average working American, if you meet those two simple requirements, what will happen? It'll put about $5,000 cash or more straight into your pocket every year, and that can start this year. That's from the new additional tax refunds available only to home-based business owners. Here's the best thing. You do not need to wait until April 15th to collect these new additional tax refunds. You can collect a portion of that refund each and every month beginning this month. Just think, this increases your take-home pay by about $300 to $500 per month, and that's from the tax savings alone. That $300 to $500 does not even include the money you're going to make in the home-based business itself. Congress has passed more than 100 different tax deductions for home-based business owners, but let's just look at the top five biggest ones. Business use of your home, sometimes called the home office deduction. This has had a lot of change, and the change means it's now clearer and easier. Anyone can now qualify to have a home office, and you no longer need to have a separate room. So what's this deduction worth? Well, that depends on how much of your home you use on a regular exclusive basis for your business. If it's 12%, 17%, 26%, whatever it is, that's your business use percentage. And that business use percentage of your house payment can become a business tax deduction, even if you're renting, by the way. That business use percentage of all utilities, repairs, maintenance, insurance, all those general overhead expenses become partially tax deductible as business expenses when you have a home office deduction. Another one of the top five, which actually sometimes turns out to be the largest single category of tax deductions for a lot of home-based business owners, is business use of your personal vehicle. A lot of people don't take advantage of this because they think the money's not big enough, or they think their record keeping is too difficult. Let me dispel both of those. Here's what the money is worth. Next time you get in your car, push that button on your dashboard to set your trip recorder to zero, and put a stack of dollar bills on your passenger seat. Unless you have a passenger there, then put it on her lap. When you start driving and you see you've driven 2 miles, roll down your driver's side window and throw a dollar bill out the window and watch it blow away in your rearview mirror. When you see you've driven 2 more miles, now it says 4 on your trip recorder, right? Throw another dollar bill out the window, watch it blow away in your rearview mirror. Do that for as long as you can stand it until you realize what you're doing is throwing away a dollar's worth of tax deduction for every 2 miles you drive. And most people are going to put minimum 5, usually 8 to 10,000 business miles on their car in a year. 10,000 business miles is a $5,000 tax deduction. That's not small change. And you only have to keep records for 90 days in order to get that deduction for the entire year. Number 3, hiring your children. The tax courts say a child as young as the age of 6 years old can work in your home-based business. Why would you want to have them work in your home-based business? Because the wages you pay your child is tax deductible to you as a business expense, and the income they earn from you is tax-free to them because they're a minor. Number 4, home-based business owners, and only home-based business owners, have a way of deducting 100% of their health care costs. If you don't have a home-based business, you're very limited in the amount of write-off you get in this category. But with a home-based business, you can almost always be able to write off up to 100% of all of your out-of-pocket healthcare expenses. Number 5, business travel and entertainment. The rules used to be really vague about what's deductible, what's not, under what circumstances. For example, on a business trip, if you went on the trip a little early or stayed a little late to have some fun, to visit family and friends or something, what's deductible? Now the rules are much easier to understand. In fact, they're crystal clear. They're so clear that we can use those rules to help us plan our trip before we even leave on the trip in order to maximize our business tax deductions. Okay, those are the top 5 tax breaks for home-based business owners. Now, you've heard that knowledge is power, right? You believe that? I do. But then, if knowledge is power, what's lack of knowledge? I think lack of knowledge is expensive, real expensive, if the knowledge you lack is about home business tax breaks. Lack of knowledge in this area has already cost you over $100 this week alone. And unless you get into home-based business and learn about these huge tax breaks, you're going to continue to overpay your taxes week after week after week, year after year. You've just discovered the secret to slashing your taxes by thousands of dollars while creating a powerful new stream of income at the same time. So what do you do now? First, contact the person who sent you this video. Then get into business with them. Do it now. Get into home-based business first, then we'll show you how to capture all the special tax breaks we've been discussing. I'm Dr. Ron Mueller, and I want to thank you for watching.